In 1952, the Aerodynamics Section of the National Advisory Committee for Aeronautics, NACA, forerunner of NASA, began to build on the pioneering work of Bell Aircraft Corporation's Robert Woods, who had co-designed the X-1, X-2, and X-5. The NACA resolved to increase its program dealing with the problems of unmanned and manned flight in the upper stratosphere at altitudes between 12 and 50 miles, 20 to 80 kilometers, and at Mach numbers between 4 and 10, or 5,000 to 12,000 kilometers per hour. A preliminary proposal for a hypersonic aircraft came from a colleague of Woods at Bell. Walter Dornberger was a former engineer on Nazi Germany's design program for the V-2 rocket bomb of World War II, the only air vehicle to have reached Mach 5 and able to withstand the high atmospheric forces and frictional temperatures associated with high-speed flight, albeit briefly. Woods developed the idea into a detailed proposal that would become the X-15, though North American Aviation, not Bell, would produce the vehicle. In conducting its mission to explore the limits of speed and even venture above the atmosphere to the edge of space, the X-15 program would provide valuable data for use in solving the problems to be encountered in spaceflight, especially atmospheric re-entry. NACA's work on the design began in 1954. At that time, thermodynamics, the study of heat and energy, in relation to frictional heating at high Mach numbers, was an unknown quantity. As it turned out, heating effects on the aircraft were somewhat overestimated, but the aircraft did require heat-resistant titanium alloy to be used in much of its structure. Another unknown was stability of an aircraft at such speeds. Directional instability had previously been encountered by the X-1 and X-2 in particular. The surprising solution to the tail design was conceived by C.H. McClellan, who abandoned the usual thin supersonic airfoil section and instead introduced a 10-degree wedge shape with a flat trailing edge. Despite the high drag the wedge imposed at low speeds, it proved to be many times more effective for stability at high speed and a great improvement over the earlier X-planes. The wings were trapezoid-shaped, with an extremely thin thickness-to-chord ratio of 5%, though not as thin as the Lockheed F-104's 3.6%, and equally extreme aspect, span-to-mean-chord ratio of just 2.5, similar to that of the F-104. A counterintuitive feature was the positioning of the horizontal tailplanes. Instead of being located high above or below the wing plane to avoid interaction with the wing's shockwaves, they were mounted in the wing plane. That placed them between regions of high downwash from the wings depending on speed. The X-15 flight test program between 1959 and 1968 was begun at Edwards Air Force Base, California, by Scott Crossfield, and continued by a dozen U.S. Air Force, NASA, U.S. Navy and North American Aviation pilots, of whom the most notable was Neil Armstrong. Like the X-1 and X-2, the X-15 had to be air-launched, but now from a wing pylon beneath a B-52 Stratofortress, the B-58 Hustler was initially favored but replaced by the B-52, instead of the bomb bay of a B-29 or B-50 Superfortress. Three X-15s were built. The first two survived the test program, but the third was destroyed in 1967 when it came apart at Mach 5, killing its pilot, Major Michael Adams. Some 200 flights were made, with the modified second aircraft, X-15A2, attaining a maximum altitude of 354,200 feet, piloted by Joe Walker on the 22nd of August 1963, and speed of 7,274 kilometers per hour, or Mach 6.7, piloted by William Knight on the 10th of March 1967, which were unofficial world absolute records for a winged aircraft. That altitude qualifies as a spaceflight, according to the Fédération Aéronautique Internationale, which defines space as beginning at a height of 100 kilometers, or 330,000 feet. In fact, by the USAF's definition of space, all flights over 80 kilometers, 264,000 feet, earned the pilot astronaut wings. For comparison, in 1963, a rocket-assisted F-104A Starfighter, operated by NASA, reached an altitude of some 120,000 feet on a ballistic trajectory, a record for a jet set by Chuck Yeager. The pilot's controls for the X-15 were unusual. The central stick controlled pitch and roll in the atmosphere, but was later removed as it was made redundant by a hydraulically boosted joystick on the pilot's right. A left-hand joystick operated the peroxide thrusters in the nose and wingtips for control in spaceflight. Cockpit heating and pressurization was provided by vapor from a liquid nitrogen system, as was the pilot's full pressure suit. X-15s achieved more than just high and fast flight. Taking advantage of the lack of atmosphere, the program carried out ramjet propulsion experiments, aerial photography, ultraviolet photography of stars, observations of the Earth's horizon at different wavelengths as a reference for planned spacecraft stabilization systems, atmospheric density measurements, micrometeoroid collection, and measurements of the intensity, polarization, and spectral distortion of light. Considering all its findings, the US $300 million X-15 program was considered a bargain.